Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper. It's the problem that won't go away. I said yesterday that we had two great ideas. The other one was from Mike Gel Gervin. Now, Mike and I are talking a lot because we're doing the dueling podcast. And when the podcast first came out, I said, wow, that one, that's a tough one. And then he came up with an idea that I recognize is a pretty good idea, not as complicated as what Gary sent in yesterday. Let's just, you know, Mike said, why don't we sort that data so that way it's all together in the original data set? And so I'm just going to add a new column here called yes. And we're going to write some sort of a formula here. So equal and. Couple of things. We want to see if this is equal to the word data. Capitalize it right. And also, maybe if this column is equal to 1, 2, 3, if both of those are true, we're going to get trues, and those are the ones we care about. All right, now, you know, Mike is saying just sort by that column H, then we can make the changes to that block. And he said, and if the data has to remain in this original sequence, let's add a column over here called the sequence column, and that is a perfect idea. Put in the one and the two, select them both, double click the fill handle. So now the advantage is we can sort this data. I'll sort to bring all the trues to the top. Now we can do any sort of transformation that we want to do. So if we have to do an edit replace, they're all there in a nice contiguous block. Replace all, click OK, and then to get it back into the original sequence, we come back here to our original sequence column, click A to Z, and now we've changed those block of records, that subset of records, but thankfully because of the sequence column, we're able to get it back into the original data set. Now it looks like we've gone through and changed all those individual records. Great way to go. I like Mike's approach. I want to thank Mike for sending that in. And I guess, and of course, thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.